Hello and welcome back to another episode of The Darkest Dungeon. What should we do? Don't really know. Maybe we should get some money with Ellie and Bagel and this sort of crew here. We have plenty of people at level 3 who can still get to level 4 and be capable of doing the boss. We never did find our Vestal, or at least we still haven't. I am more and more tempted to start accepting and just discarding people. I am slightly tempted to keep increasing the size of the stagecoach network so that we can at least have some opportunity here. But all these level 2s and 1s are basically going to be waiting for that. So I think what we might do is figure out which sort of party we're going to want to take to beat the hag. And I think it's going to involve... I don't really want to take Tim at that level of stress. But also, I think it probably should. Because the hag sits at the back. But the hag's going to take people out of the rotation. So everybody we take will have to hit the back. Which means we should not take Psycho, but we should take Holmesy, right? No. Well, it's the back two. They're both... It's two units of two, so it's either of the back two. But I think what we might actually do, therefore, is hang on to that, but instead level up a few more people. We'll take Bagel for healing. We might as well take Ellie for money. So we'll make it a money mission, and we will do just a... Everyone just left. Might have to be a long mission, but I'm slightly reluctant to do that. So it might have to be two episodes, so do prepare yourselves for that. What is your malfunction? That's okay. And then we'll go back in here, and we'll open up the blacksmith, and we'll actually level up these units. Yeah. I mean, we're going to be getting money back anyway. Might as well. I'd rather you didn't die. What does this do? Damage. Dodge. Now we have no money. Brilliant. I don't really know how to provision for a long mission. And I may have just scuppered it by doing that. But we'll see. Let's take all our trinkets back. Right click. There we go. Sort by class restriction. We'll do this. Less stress is okay. But we'll do that. You might as well take the dodge. Even with the debuff resist, it seems better. What do we normally give you? Manhater? Accuracy in position 4. There's a ranged accuracy somewhere. I think we want that. Or damage. Maybe there's ranged damage. Or damage versus human? We are going to the Warrens. There's a lot of beasts. So we're already good at beast. Well, we haven't got any... Snolan, how have you not got any quirks? Less damage with torch above 75. We should probably get rid of that. But not right now. And a long mission with a antiquarian. This could be fun. Prepare yourselves that we may actually abandon this mission. We want... There's another book. Another book. This one. Yes. Minus 20% chance. More scouting chance? Sure. I mean, you're not going to do much other than buffers, so... And then the standard amazing pair of things here. We probably should not have given Pete the extra stress damage thing. So what I'm going to do here is actually try and find the other one, which is just... excuse me. That one, yes. 15%. Where are you? There. It's not as good, but we can still get some decent crits off. I think we should be okay with these. I'm wondering whether to give this unit some protection, or maybe this one. I mean, this is basically required. We'll just do it. Provision. We've got some dog treats, which is tasty. We should probably take 2 stacks of food. And 2 stacks of torches. Then we're going to take some herbs. I mean, it is a mission where we're going to try and collect some stuff, but mostly we'll be collecting money, I would suggest. Money and antiques. And money is going to stack higher, and antiques are going to stack high too. I think we just embark like this. We don't want to, we don't want to fill up our inventory on stuff on the way in. We just want to be able to get through the mission, you know, quit, finish, succeed, not take too much stress retreating.
They breed
what odd shape.
Quickly down there in the dark.
Room battles.
Perhaps we can slay them even faster.
So if we can find the room battles, we know exactly where to go to avoid them. There's no way of avoiding this, like the battle on the way to here, so we're going to have to do that. Let's check our positioning. I think we're in the right position. Yeah. I mean, I guess I should have taken blackjack here rather than this one, but it's done, so at least I remembered the trinkets. We can't have everything. Mercurio. It's a good start. You. This is your job. This crate is empty, but there's an antique inside it. There is not. Right, room battle with treasure. Torch. Round one fight. Ding ding. Okay, we've seen this before. I think they're just higher HP versions of what we had before. We have a debuff already. Brilliant. And some stress. And they're all going first because apparently we are incapable of having a party with any amount of speed at all. You're already flipping out. This is too much stress. Stop it. Kill that. I said kill it. Not. At least you hit it, I suppose. I think we just really wanted to kill this.
Continually onslaught.
HP again. Recoverable. Stress. Less so. Did resist both of the debuffs you could have got from that. 3 is a bad roll, Bagel. Thank you. Everyone dodge. Don't forget we've only got... Well, we've got way less DPS than we normally would with this unit. We could still Scarpa and bring back all the stuff that we collected. But here, I'm just trying to get through an episode, man. Get to the next day. Probably didn't need to heal at that stage, but I think it's much easier... Well, not easier, but more sensible. Like, that was completely the wrong order of affairs. But it's much more sensible for you to keep you healed. What have we got here? Than it would be to, you know, like, let it get down and then try and keep up later. We could bleed everything, but I think we'd find the thing with a prop. Mark it. Debuff it. And then attack it in future. Don't really want to hit that. If it bleeds is a highly conditional statement, but apparently it does bleed, which means it can be killed. That's okay, you're just a... Just an antiquarian. You can actually heal yourself. I may do. The dodge buff is fine, but people not dying is probably a better outcome. The Black Plague. Well done. You could have killed it or anything. What does that do? That may actually be worth just abandoning right now. 21 damage on that. Can I have a look at Tim, please? 75, it's not terrible, but it is still fairly awful to have just got it at the start of, if we had had that before we embarked, there's no way we would have come out. I need you to kill this.
Disadvantage. Give them no quarter.
That's actually a pretty decent attack, in fairness. Oh, apparently you're back there. Well,
obliterated.
More fool you. Good job, Tim. We need... That's the sort of thing we need. Ah, and you dodged. Thank you, Ellie, for making that round a much better round than it could have been. I really need Bagel to have a go. So if you could, thank you. I needed him to have that go. More like that, and with the resist, and... You're dead. That actually went really well, apart from the fact that Tim got the fucking plague. Well done, Tim. You absolute Noob. Who the hell gets the plague? The black plague as well. Of all plagues. We could, until camp. If you eat these, do you get rid of everything? Combat debuffs. Yes. TIL, but okay. This is your job. This is what we're here for. Mad loots. We can't hit the back. Because there isn't a back. So that's the thing. We want to debuff you. Excellent. Tiny bit of protect. Oh, I actually wanted to debuff you, but okay. More dodging by Ellie is outstandingly useful. Vomit. Another dodge. You keep doing that, and you can come on all these missions. In fact, I will heal you as a reward, whereas previously I was quite prepared to not bother at all. Don't admit that. Probably try and, if it bleeds, this thing. Oh, that was a medium roll, I guess. That at least has now put a timer on how long that thing has to live. Ellie, you didn't dodge that, but I will let you off. Because if you can do enough damage to this, which you can, that's dead. Sweet! Hounds rush this. Maybe we try and get rid of that. Seven to 13. 13 is actually the higher of those two numbers. I'm not sure if you're aware of how, you know, relative magnitude of values works. No. Yes. But at least it puts it... Well, it gets one more go, alas. It does vomit on Ellie. We dodged it again. Dodging vomit is something that Ellie is apparently extremely good at. This is how a life is. So, Emma, you know what to do. Ellie's going to be a nurse when she grows up. Not brilliant. But, I mean, we had minus 33% and still got a... you're dead, right? We still got a bleed of 10. Wow. 18 damage and a bleed. It does debuff us for 3 rounds. Who cares? Crit for 33. This is going to be another one of those missions where we slowly, over time, get whittled down. Unforgiving. And we start thinking that we're doing really, really well. And then, no. Here's a one battle that just owns the shit out of you. Should probably use a torch. And then you get deaded. Surprise. Cool. I mean, what do we want to kill? These are beasts. That's a human beast. We could potentially one-shot that. What's our... I'd like it to not have a go. So what we do here is we do the damage that we can. It's got a bleed, which is on 2, so that needs to do 9. So then we, if it bleeds it again, which is 6 to 12, plus another bleed, which is 10, which is more than enough. Right, that's dead. You are going to keep healing Ellie, because Ellie's been doing really well, although that was a heal of 1. I'm not sure if you're aware that that is not enough. In fact, that is less than enough. In fact, that is so much less than enough that we are now worse off than we were before you did it. A vomit on Tim gives Tim the other Black Plague. Nope. Munch on Ellie puts Ellie at death's door, no doubt. Oh, not quite. This is bad. As long as you keep hitting different people, I'll be okay. Alright, Bagel needs to go first. Do it right this time. Thank you. Very valuable. I'm not sure how you get 1. if you're going to get plus 15%, I guess it is what it is. 7 to 13, we could just one-shot these. That would be nice. We could. I chose that one because we have more units that can hit that position than we have units that can hit the other, well, and that position, but that's not one of those. Goodness me, Ellie. Keep doing that. Very valuable. And then Tim. It's not... Our bleeds are always one fucking point less than they need to be. But I'm going to hit this. That was a bit of a gamble. Wasn't anticipating the crit. I was anticipating getting a bleed off on that thing. That's a bit of a kill plus situation going on. It gives us some damage over time on this unit. Plus, there's a dodge. As you're doing the damage to it, plus killing that. Keep dodging. I'm happy with this dodge benefit you're giving everybody. 21 dodge is a really good amount. It actually helped us dodge for once, which is super. Just bleed out this. Yep. Look at all this stuff we've already got. Expedition at least promises success. Rubies are worth 1,000. That's worth 250, so that dull green like rotting flesh. That's what jade is. So we go this way. I think we avoid this. It's kind of 6 and 2 3s, to be honest. But there is a curio here, and we do have an antiquarian, so maybe we will not go that way, but we will go down here. Did we bring shovels? Please tell me we brought shovels. Guy, I didn't bring any shovels. So we're going to have to avoid that. This could be a problem, although there are ways around everything. But we have to do that. So maybe we should go this way? Yeah, I'm going to go that way. It avoids... not much, really. Just makes it slightly more efficient. I feel better about it, okay? Hunger. Probably not going to be too happy if we get many more of those. Have to be honest. Don't forget we can camp twice. We should probably figure out where. Somewhere over here and somewhere over here. I mean, this is not as huge a thing as I'd expect it to be. But don't forget we've got a lot of back and forth thing to do. I think that's where the problems are going to come in. Oh, what is this? This is the egg for 5 minutes, Tim. You ain't doing shit now. Got no HP, no speed. Oh my goodness. We might have to quit this just so that Tim can go and get cured of these bullshit diseases, for fuck's sake. Beast. 8 to 14. Good. That's a good roll. Don't know what this thing does. We can pray. Pretty sure I'm not going to be pleased with it, whatever it is. Kill that. Good. Right, now we only have one thing to worry about. And worry about it, I shall. I'm quite worried about it. What I'm not worried about is running away and dealing with the stress that causes us. That is fine. We didn't take any damage as far as I know. I am pretty sure that was a zero damage attack, which I'm happy with. That was a 5-point bleed. I did not realise that. Well, now we debuff it, I guess. Well, marking it will help. It will give us a much greater damage output from Hound's Rush. 80%. Huge amount. Less dodge. Less damage. I'm sure this thing must have a damaging attack as well. It can't continually do weak and prey. That would be silly. What are we on? 7. 14. Tim, how have you not dodged any of this stupid plague nonsense that you keep getting? You can actually if it bleeds this, which is... it's not as good as a single hit than bleed out. But as bleed out, but also it's still really, really, really good. So, happy with it. Keep doing no damage, if you don't mind. Apart from the fact you resisted the debuff again. You're going to do this for 15 damage, which is a large quantity of its damage, of its HP, at this stage. Haven't really needed to force any ally to protect you, because apparently you are the hardest thing to hit anyway. As are you. This dodge debuff is super useful. Maybe just bleed out. Oh yeah, perfect. Size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. A leper amulet. 15 damage of position 1, less virtue chance. That's probably pretty good to take. We haven't really used the leper, and I have said that I don't know how. But mostly... I mean, that's kind of true to a large extent. But it's also pretty simple. You just hit things with it, you see? That's the first time Ellie's actually had a problem there. More food if stress is above 50. At least it replaced something. Slow draw. Not really something I was worried about Ellie having, but... it is what it is. Probably should have used a torch, but never mind. Surprised? No. Right, so now we really need to get rid of this properly. We could crit it. I mean, if we were ever going to use those doggy treats, we would have used them on the last attack, right? How about you get another disease? Yeah? No? Alright. Oh, some stress then. Oh, yeah. Just have a crit on a stress attack. Tim. Do we need to have a talk? Seriously, what is happening? Oh my goodness. Everything's just wailed away on Tim. Is that just really bad dice rolls? It must be. These things can't have the tactics to do that, right? I assume. I don't know. As long as we keep rolling more than 4, I'll be happy. Iron Swan. Well, you've got shitty damage now. So, I'm happy that you hit it at all, I suppose. Oh yeah, get another disease. And some more stress. Resisted the debuff, which is fine. Is this a... Yeah, that's counteracting this. Maybe I should have given Tim the herbs. The herbs. 2 damage. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. Get rid of that thing. Hate it. Jesus Christ. Everything is attacking Tim. And you've got another disease. Forgive me for being salty, but that is really the theme of these high-level episodes. It's only level 4. It's not high level yet. Why is everything attacking Tim? Can we talk about this? Literally everything has aimed directly at Tim and given him 3 diseases. He's doing it again! Stop attacking Tim. Attack somebody else. Now Tim's going to be on death's door and might actually die on his next turn. That's not even Tim. Oh my god. It's been Doug all along. I'm so silly. I do apologise. I thought we brought Tim along in the first place because that would have been a very clever idea. Well, I apologise to Doug for calling him Tim all this time. Right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to heal you. It's because I was shouting at Tim in the last episode. And then you just heal his entire HP all at once. And you're doing 10 blight damage. Right, calm down. If it bleeds... No, I want to bleed out this one, because we're going to... Yeah. We're going to use Snolan to attack that. How has that been dug all along? Why did nobody tell me? Well, you all make mistakes, right? Let's move on from that. Wow, that's a bunch of stuff.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
I kind of prefer the portraits at this stage. We have got 12 of these anyway. Maybe it's about time we camped. I think it is. We could certainly do with the de-stressing.
Huddled together,
eat some food.
Furtive and vulnerable. Rats in a maze.
We didn't have to use all 8 food there. I thought it might have been the sensible thing. I'd like to get more surprise on monsters, just in general, so that seems like a good start. Remove bleed, remove blight. That is a 2 time cost. Probably should do that. One of these has mortality debuffs, which I think is this one. And heals 50% though, so maybe we should wait. What's this? Less accuracy, less damage, less speed, more stress. Doug, you're completely useless now. Oh, heavens. 6 damage for 2 rounds. I think I'd rather spend the time to get rid of that. Now everyone's at least basically full HP. We've already got no nighttime ambush. 1 companion. All the resistances. It's going to be you. That at least makes up for some of the diseases you've picked up. That's a ridiculous amount of disease. And the fact that it all got on one character... I assume those things are just always attacking the front character, and what I'm supposed to do is move them around. But I didn't prepare for that. We don't really have moving-around type characters. Okay, so you're going to basically try and... I guess you do this. Nothing else seems valuable. 50% scouting chance. It's only 4 combats, although we will be able to do this all again. Yeah, I think now's a good time to have the scout chance, and then later, when that Doug-Tim combo unit here It's in a really bad way.
A blazing star is born.
You know, we can start thinking about using the other things to improve that. We don't have a thing to get rid of the obstacles, so we're going to have to snake around here. It was a very early camp. Earlier than I would have liked. More antiques. Yep. Reward for a task well right, one of you's got a really good trap disarm. Yep. Yeah. Thank you, Snolan. Would have liked it if Doug here was able to disarm traps a bit more. I could have taken the risk and tried to reduce the stress a little bit, but I think I'd just rather have the trap disarmed. That's a really good scouting opportunity, actually. There's an obstacle on both sides of that stupid thing. Well, hopefully there isn't one here. Or maybe we just find a shovel. Can't believe I came out without shovels. I'm always so vigilant about them. I talk about them all the time. Oh, what a foolish maneuver. That's some food there, though. Right, you're going to eat this. Then. You're going to eat the crap out of that. Ooh, so close. Well, you're dead now. So we get some stress on Doug. That's fine. We lose some light. That's also fine. Put some light back. Then we start dodging everybody again. Everyone's back at full HP. It's only stress we have to worry about now, which is very likely to happen. Like, we can't do too much to get rid of this, even in camp. This is a bit of a shame. I suppose we try and reduce your... We'll get rid of its dodge first. It does have some. And we critted. It's marked, which means you don't need to do the mark. It resisted the debuff, though, which is not ideal. And you can, if it bleeds it, with your considerably reduced... damage. But the bleed is not reduced in damage, which is really nice. Keep going with this. That thing is going to die when it bleeds out. There we go. We can pray is okay. Does a bit of damage, but not much. Resisted the debuff. The mark is fine. And now we weaken it so that hopefully next time it does that, if there's a next time, it doesn't hurt. That's a considerable amount of damage, actually. For saying that you have now actually got no damage. I think it was worth using the dog treats for that.
Unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
I think inordinate exsanguination is probably one of my favourite things to happen to anything ever. There's only food here, unfortunately. Which does help, because we've got another camp coming up. But I suppose this is worth... We're going to find more of these than these, so we should take that in place of that. But really, do we want the food? What can we afford to get rid of? To take that much food. Maybe another medicinal herbs? I know that it would debuff us. We probably should have just straight up used it. Why didn't I do that? It's only two rounds, though. Torch first, yeah, definitely.
The way is lit. The path is clear.
I'm hoping I can get into that other room without there being an obstacle in the third direction, because that would just be a massive pain in the arse. But everything else is really well connected, so hopefully we can get around without having to worry about the fact we didn't bring a shovel. What are we going to do here? Try and kill this? Some damage here and an iron swan might be just enough to do that. Oh, God. We have to kill everything. Because these things are going to attack Doug again. Incessantly and without mercy. Dodge speed. That's actually really good. We didn't use the iron swan, but it does mean we can use something else to maybe completely eradicate one of these. Or a yowp. 70% stun. It kind of makes me think maybe not. Bleed is 3, which is not great. Oh, you're munching someone else. So it didn't always have to attack Doug, who at the time was Tim. When I was complaining about it. It's just they constantly chose to keep racking on the damage. I don't think he was marked, and even if he was marked... Oh, now you've got syphilis. There you go. There's a lot of disease in this run, I'll be honest. Like, a considerably large amount of disease compared to what you'd expect. We might as well use a curse and kill this. It at least gives us one fewer thing to worry about. Can we get rid of this? We'll probably get rid of this. Yeah, we can. That's probably a very good use of Ellie. I do like that buff that we have, but just completely getting rid of something. 100%. Super nice. Dodge. Dodge. Very dodgy unit. It's not something you necessarily always think about, but even though the Antiquarian doesn't really have a vast array of attacks or even damage, it's not got a huge amount of value in combat. A dizzying fall. Oh, I want the deeds. Get rid of those. The fact that it is a unit that can take a hit and dodge it makes it incredibly valuable, because then something else that is less likely to dodge doesn't get hit. There's a trap and I've only just noticed. Do you know what? What is your... Trap disarm is 90%. I think we try it. Get rid of some of your stress. That was actually very worth it. It took us down a visual pip. It wasn't as much as a whole pip represents, but it feels better. And purpose is made clear. We didn't open that curio on purpose because it was a totem of some description. Another torch is actually welcome for the first time in one long mission and one medium mission so far. We have actually found a torch. And some food, which is what I was banking on in the previous mission. Oh my goodness.
Paid for in blood.
12 of those or 2 of those. Kind of think maybe get rid of the torches. We're getting to the stage now where we don't want to get rid of anything, but we don't want to keep everything either. I'll discard them under the assumption that at some point in the future, we're going to find more, and we're still not going to have inventory space then. Basically, we're going to discard something at some point in the future that will require us to, you know, find room. So it might as well be this. Oh, that's pretty good. Overgrown weather. And they are surprised, but we did buff ourselves for that, which is nice. 2 combats left on these resists. These are beasts, right? Yeah, they must be. So there's a good chance of killing it. There's a good chance of missing it, as it turns out. Maybe we should weirdly reconstruct somebody. Yeah, that wasn't their full HP, so that was actually worth doing. I'm just going to try and kill one at least before it gets a go. I have a habit of aiming at the second unit, irrespective of what I'm doing. Mostly because I have a... I'm getting used to the Hellion being around, which can only hit really reliably that unit there. Well, this one can anyway. Yeah. No. Oh, you get another go, do you? That's the thing about stuns, is you have... about surprises, you don't really get an idea of the turn order, at least the likely turn order, because obviously it changes each time. Can you just kill it? No, not quite. That's okay. Doug will do it. Yeah, you don't have stabby. You have bleed out, but not just straight up stab. Cleansed from our land. Some more money. Okay. Remind yourself that overconfidence. This can stack up to 2,000. Insidious killer. So it's worth having room for that. That's not worth really opening at all, I think. There's unlikely to be a shovel in there, that's for sure. It's a shame we have to do all room combats instead of just scout all rooms, because then we could have just avoided this one completely. Oh, that's not good. It's only Doug, apparently. Doug is the scapegoat for this particular mission, when just takes all the stress and all the diseases and all the everything that could ever go wrong. Let's invigorate ourselves here a little bit. Seems like a good starting turn. I think what we want to do here is actually this one. It's quite painful. Ah, that's a human beast, actually. That's a beast. And that one's causing all the disease, so that one needs to die. And then Doug Tim can do the... Yeah, great dodge. Iron Swan and kill the shit out of it. Is that going to be a... Don't know. What's Ball and Chain do, then? Yeah, it's a move and a stun. Perfect. So that's the really ouchy one out of the way. Less dodge is probably what we want on this. Just do a modicum of damage, but it's not anything really. It's not gonna... Well, it could be the difference between life and death literally, because... Ooh, all that damage, that was amazing. Because of the mark, which I'd forgotten you can do. So I'm going to do that on you as well. Even though it's a dodge one, was that mark? No. Even though that is the dodge one rather than the protection remover, that did actually have dodge, as it turns out. Look, you've made that mistake before. Ow. Having the mark, I think, will probably more than make up for it. Okay, no crit this time. That's a shame. 15. The protection again will be ridding us of some of that. So this doesn't mark, you see, so it does... That removes damage. Yours is the mark and prop remover. So, yeah, having a mark from that thing, although it doesn't remove the protection, was worthwhile, I think. What are we on here? 2 damage per round at 15. Can't hit that. I think we just keep doing this. Having the extra dodges is turning out to be really useful, and as noted, Ellie can absorb an attack every so often and basically dodges most of them. I mean, not that one, obviously. It's 9 damage there. Probably going to wait a turn before we heal that, because there's no point having an overkill heal when it's just going to be removed anyway. We do want to heal up Snolan a bit. So we probably should do that. For 2! Oh, very good. 2 of the 12 that were needed. I mean, we're likely to kill this anyway. So that wasn't ideal, but... Oh, there's a shovel. Great. As victories mount, good fucking timing. So too will resistance. You know what? I don't care. Leave it. We can leave this way. It's not going to be a big deal. Don't want that. The light will not go down too far, and we'll bleed off the bleeds, as it were. And then we can go this way. So many battles in between them as well, have you noticed? There is a secret door here, but we don't have a key. We have so much stuff already. Like, what do I care about the... Oh, we're not there yet. What do I care about the extra stuff we could get out of that anyway? It's going to be a lot. Like, 3 of those prismatic thingies. But they don't stack. So I need 3 spaces, and they're worth less than these stacks of gold. So unless we can figure out how to get a key and 3 spaces worth of inventory. I was just thinking we're going to get one of these. Which is why I put the light up. Not because I was expecting to surprise them, but because I was thinking it's going to go down some more because of that thing. Just goes to show how right you can be. Not too happy with Snolan going first here. I think we should get rid of these because they're really fucking annoying. That's why. Pardon my French, but Jesus fucking Christ. You heal that. Wow, very good. Bit of a nominal amount of stress heal there. In fact, I don't think you had any stress. In fact, it seems like you don't give a shit. It's a bad actual damage roll, but the 3 bleed per round is nice. You're gonna die. You dodged the Eldritch push. It's good that we got the opportunity to put this on first. How long have we been going here? 40 minutes. So we're actually going quite quickly through this. I was worried that we'd have to turn it into 2 episodes. And I should probably set myself up some way of noticing when we've got to a long way so I can judge that. But I think we'll be okay here, actually. Maybe we should re-weird construct... excuse me, Snolan here. That was worth it. Probably overkill, but if you keep dodging, I'll be happy. You've got... Well, you can hit that, so... Maybe we can just yelp and get them both dead. What are you on? 2 and 2, so you do that. I didn't need to do that, to be fair. But it really makes no odds. If it bleeds, it's fine. It's the bleed out that does us a self-debuff. Which is an interesting mechanic that I'm not quite sure about. Obviously, it's a finishing move, or at least a move when you don't feel like you're going to these nightmarish creatures be in a difficult situation afterwards. Yes, we can take those. Brilliant. That's 1,000 gold. That's quite a lot of gold in that stack there. Really in it for the money. We did spend a lot of money on upgrading these units, but remember, these units are probably going to be the ones we take for the bosses. Another surprise. Can't get enough of this. Right. Yes. And then? Now, do we try and kill something outright, like this, or do we set ourselves up for the next turn? We could, between us, kill that. And then I think if we set up the next turn with a mark on this from you, yeah, from you. Put a mark on this, remove the dodge from it, which is not a high dodge. And then we, if it bleeds on this, which has got, yeah. It's not gonna die from that bleed, so now we're happy. Continue to dodge the stress attacks and I will be extremely pleased. It's an interesting place to put yourself. Dodge? No. But we can't dodge them all, but the amount that Ellie does dodge has more than made up for the fact that she's taken all those actual attacks in the first place. It's not like she's ever been near death or even slightly stressed out, which is lucky. She's actually done really well on this mission, and I'm actually very surprised. We now deal with, what's this? Two rounds. Probably just want to... Yeah. 11. Not a great roll. And another 2 damage there. Maybe we should try and heal Ellie here. She only has 30 HP. It's actually... only. We've basically all got that. Okay, then. Maybe we de-damage one of these. I mean, this one has more goes to it. That's all I can really think about there. Ah, probably worth it. Resisted all that stuff, so it's just 2 damage against Doug.
Easy.
Another dodge. So definitely was the correct one to de-damage. De-claw, I suppose. Oh, a push. Actually, that's a new one. Well done. Now I guess we just hit this. I can deal with these things you're giving me. 5 damage, 11. Dodge? Yeah. I don't like the Hellions being in the middle without a charge. Without a way through. But I guess we can do this. Slightly a wasted move. It's not my favourite. Well done on dodging that one so often. It's extremely valuable. It's basically a kill on that. It's just delayed. Yeah. That's probably really exactly what I wanted to do. Been resisting all these bleeds, which is superb. It's another kill plus everything has... Well, that one didn't get a bleed, apparently, but there you go. I think I will move you. I would like to be able to use bleed out, I think. What? Can't dodge. Not too much stress on that unit, but that is quite a lot to be gained all at once. Dodge? Yay! If I just keep saying dodge, then there's a stronger chance it will work, at least. That's what I was led to believe in this book I read. Now we do... I guess we do this again. Oh, can we bring something into death range? Not really. What's our dodges? 7. I think we just keep invigorating ourselves and hope we don't get pushed again by that unit. So we try and get rid of that unit, which is dodging a lot, apparently. Well, to be fair, we dodged her attacks. No. What goes around comes around. See it, saw it. To me, to you. What are we on? 5 and you've got 7. So if we do 2, which we can... We're guaranteed if we use that one. So the only reason I did that was in order to ensure that it died. That's a good dodge. And let me just try and get rid of this. 10. Most of it. There's 2 there. Kill it. Probably a good idea. Another 1,000, even more gold we just can't take. Push on to the task's end. So I think we think about camping again to try and get rid of this taken up inventory space. But what I'm going to do is not eat all the food. I'm going to keep one stack, well, 1/4 of food left. So 4. Can we go somewhere else first? Let's see if there's going to be combat here. There is not. So we can get a little bit closer to that. And therefore the end. And I'm going to use Doug again to get rid of this. de-stress Doug a little bit. There is a reasonable chance that failed. There's a free torch, which is nice, because I just used one.
If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
If only. And then we use this. I don't expect that, we take stress if we don't eat. Oh, that's interesting. We can eat two food and take no stress, but also get no HP. But this will starve us, basically, and hurt. So, interesting that... Not what I'm saying. I intentionally didn't use this curio, because there's one up here, which is actually a statue of some description, so we may have still got something. But there's other stuff, is basically the point here. We'll do this again, because this... Actually, I'm not too bothered about an ambush this time around. We're doing really well for this being a long run. But I'm going to try and reduce... You've been fine. I really don't care. This camp was not actually all that necessary. Do we need scouting? No. We might as well do this. At least you've got disease resist in there, which actually... Actually worth it. Produces a random trinket. Do I want to fill that slot with a trinket? Guess so. Disease charm. Disease resist. We should be taking those with us, shouldn't we? What have you got instead? Bleed chance. What have you got? Yeah, we should be taking those more often, I expect. Just because... I don't know how unlucky we've been, or whether that's to be expected. You know? I guess we might as well just heal up. We're not doing anything else with our stuff. I'm tempted to see if this is any good. Less stress damage. Reduce stress for everybody. But we get less accurate and less fast. For 4 combos. Let's do it! We've not used it before. We've de-stressed everybody by a huge amount. And in fact, if we'd taken enough herbs, we could have removed those debuffs. That's interesting. We should definitely try and remember that in future. We'll go here. Not too concerned about that. Could be something decent in it, but I don't really intend to. It's not that we have any herbs left. And apparently we're not being surprised anymore. Marked. Great. Torch, please. Okay. You. Don't have the man-hater anymore. You've got a high dodge, actually. That's interesting. Considering you haven't been. 5 to 9. Do we still have... No. In that case, we might as well go for... I want you to put that back on. This, because it hasn't been yet. Don't know. I suppose it was a bleed attack, so we should not have gone for the one that can actually bleed. That was a bit of a mistake. But you can kill that. Which stops it from going. So maybe it wasn't a mistake, but it was an accidental correct thing to do, not an intentional correct thing to do, which means it wasn't the right thing to do at all. You have a huge amount of dodge, so you're going to lose it if I can. Nope. The mark helps, though. And we'll if it bleeds, you. You didn't dodge it, even though you got 21 dodge. That's 3 damage, and you got 4, obviously. Oh, now you've got 4. No dodge there, but we did remove more than that much stress in camp. What's this one? Let's dodge. Our attempts to make ourselves completely incapable of combat have yet to bite us in the ass, but give it time, I'm sure. We've got here. 3 damage, 4 HP. That doesn't please me. Maybe I should have used them... it doesn't really matter. I was thinking maybe I should have used the hex or something to do enough damage to bring it into range, but whatever. Just stab a lot. Yeah, bleed. Bleed the fuck out. think that was peace the fuck out. Stereophonics, was it?
Victory.
But victory,
nonetheless.
It was a victory nonetheless. We've got a whole extra stack of food and I haven't even realised. That was just daft. Because we would have de-stressed if we'd eaten all of that food. Oh, what a lack of attention I have been paying. And I admit to it, I agree to it. I put my hands up and I say, you got me. I was doing badly on the Isaac run that I was recording earlier on today as well, so it's just one of those days. I probably shouldn't be up this late. Also, I can't imagine that me being in bed earlier, or not being awake right now, would have had any effect on the number of diseases that Doug picked up. However, I fully expect that if I'd been more in charge of my faculties, yeah, great, fucking miss them both, I would not have been calling him Tim for the entire first half of the mission. Hooray! It was a singular strike. The only singular strike we needed. You crit that. I don't fancy him. I don't fancy that crit though. Dodge? No. Like, our dodges are really bad. So, we're just tanking this. Mostly, we're hoping not to get stressed out any more than we came in with. Still dodged, so that's okay. What is with this attacking the same person bullshit? Again. Whatever. Yeah. Oh, perfect. Decisive pummeling. He sounds like Stephen Fry. As long as we don't actually die. Yeah, that'll do it. So, Bagel, why don't you heal Snolan for all the damage he just took? Yeah. As long as we don't actually die, which is actually a fate that is looking ever more to be ours, then the stress is what we're trying to avoid. What are we on here? 3 damage, 23. You're not going to do enough damage, so we'll continue to help everyone dodge and get over the piss-up that we had at camp. I mean, maybe we should not have had a piss-up at camp. I take your point. I will keep it under advisement. Dodge. Oh! That's the first time that's done anything to us. But it's done a lot to us. Okay. Bagel's still got to go. They didn't take out the healer. That's the important thing. 9 is not really enough, but at least we've still got those bleeds not happening. And that's the important thing. If it bleeds, stack up these bleeds, get this thing dead. It will die on the next turn because Snolan will beat the shit out of it with his dog. Keep doing this. Dog, go. Hooray! I mean, it's taken so long to kill that one unit that this one's had many goes against us, which does not fill me with confidence. This, however, does. 4, 5. Well, don't have a go. Okay. I need you to heal. Well, hopefully this one won't have a go before we do. Oh well. It is what it is. Dodge it then. Alright, sorted. Yeah, no worries. Give yourself a little bit of a top-up. That seems like a good idea. Why don't you finish it off? Hope you feel better about that. Yeah, you do. Good. Take everything.
Ghoulish horrors. Brought low and driven
into the mud. So must be a battle here. We've beaten that one. Yeah, so I guess we use a torch. Get rid of the torches. Take this. Dull green, like rotten flesh. Oh no, we're done. In that case, we'll go. I think we did okay. No one died.
Their skills fade. Their confidence is shaken.
That was a lot of money as well. But I think we'll try and cut this one to be a bit less than an hour. I apologise for everyone who's faithfully and judiciously watching everything. Well, okay, you just replaced the Black Plague with another fucking disease, but at least you can only have 3 or 4 at once. But everyone's going in for thingy. I'll probably put some people in sort of between episodes, but I'm going to cut this one here. Thank you for watching and being patient on this nearly an hour long episode, and leave me some feedback as to whether you were concerned about the fact that that was an hour long. If in future, if we do more long missions, you would like me to cut them into, or if you're happy to watch, I welcome all feedback, provided I can understand it and that it is, you know, at least some semblance of grammatically sound. I don't care if it's full of abuse, in fact that's quite endearing, but if I can actually read it, I think it would have a greater effect. It would sort of hit its mark a little bit more. So yeah, tell me if you want my hour-long episodes to be divided into two, or whether you don't really mind. So until the next episode, which may again be an hour long, depending on what we find, I'll thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.